Hello, today I'm going to show you how to use custom light materials to work with the new brake light recording system within Rush Hour. With this vehicle path at the moment, I have it configured to use a standard included Rush Hour vehicle. So on here, we can see that it's using the standard Rush Hour materials, and we can see that the brake lights work. What I'm going to show you to do today is how to adjust the Epic Automotive materials to also work with this brake light system. So let's start with going to Blender. In Blender, we can see we've got this generic supercar model. You can see on this generic supercar model that I've assigned all the materials to use the same names as the Epic Automotive materials. So the MI Car Paint Red, and on the lights, the only change I've made is that I've made a new light material called MI Lamp Brake. And I'm going to show you how to set all that up within Unreal. When we use the vehicle importer, all these standard materials will be automatically applied to the new car. If we come across here now, I've already done that, and we can see on this supercar model, we can see that the car looks great and already has all those materials applied. With the exception of the light we created here, which is MI Lamp Brake. So this is a new material that was imported with this car, so we'll replace that one with a newly created one. First up, we're going to modify the original materials so they work with the light control system. So in under automotive materials, expand that out, materials, exterior, lights, and we can see that it has three lights included already: MI Lamp Blue, MI Lamp Red, and MI Lamp White. First up, we'll just duplicate the MI Lamp Red, and we'll call that MI Lamp Brake to match the material that we assigned in Blender. And now if we right click that and go find parent, it will take us to the M emissive master. So we need to do a few changes to this because this is set up as an unlit material. And when we turn the light on and off, we probably want it to be a lit material by default. So let's change that to lit, default lit. And now we're going to add in a few parameters. If we right click and go scalar and search for scalar, we can find this scalar parameter. We're going to call this on amount. And we're going to multiply the existing setup by this on amount. And if we replace that to the emissive color, we can see when we change this on amount, we can turn the light on and off. That's good. But now when the light is off, it's just a black material, which doesn't look very good. So we'll copy this color tint, and we're gonna plug that into the base color. And we're gonna create two new scalar parameters. We'll call this metallic. We want that a default of one for this case. And we'll create one more scalar parameter, which we will call roughness. And zero roughness is what we want. So now we can find that it's a very mirror-like material. That's fine for what we want here. And again, we can still turn the light on and off. So that's good. One more change I'm going to make to the brake light is I want it to be a little bit brighter by default. So if we change the on amount to one, it doesn't show up too well in the scene with these default settings. So we're gonna change the facing intensity to 20 and the edge intensity to 5. And we'll turn it back off again and we'll press save. Now we need to make sure that these are all assigned properly on the car. So going back to our imported car, on SM body, we can see that it's still using the newly imported material, but we want to change that to the one we just created within the automotive materials pack. So if we find MI Lamp Brake and make sure we're using the automotive materials one, that's now assigned on the body mesh. And now we need to adjust this light control component. This light control component is actually what changes the light state at runtime and with sequencer. So in here, it works quite simply. It just looks for any instances of these materials on the vehicle, and it swaps them out with a dynamic material instance. So here we just really need to change out what lights we're using. So we will change out the MI Light DRL with MI Lamp Blue. That's all of that one. The indicators, we're just going to change to lamp red for now. I really would recommend keeping those as separate indicator materials though. The MI lamp brake, we will change out up there. And the headlights, we will just change all to MI lamp white. I recommend creating as many light materials as you need that fits within this structure, which will allow you the most configuration on your lights. So now if we hit save and we come back over to our vehicle path and change this out to use our newly imported vehicle, we should see, if we go to the rear camera, we should see these lights turn on and off. Yep, and the brake lights came on. That's excellent. That's what we want. So we'll just check it one more time up here. Great. And now we'll just check it in sequencer as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to hit play again and pause it. We'll open up Take Recorder and we will choose our supercar actor. Using Take Recorder is covered in another tutorial. Make sure to read the documentation on the website. I'm just going to quickly gloss through this. We want to scroll down and remove root animation. Press record and then play. Excellent. So now if we come back to the content browser and open up cinematics, we can open up scene 101 and we'll open up the vehicle sequence. We'll make that non-read only and we need to come down to the vehicle mesh and turn off simulate physics. Once again, that's covered in another tutorial, so don't mind me glossing through that. Now that that's done, we're going to create a new level sequence, which we will call new level sequence demo, and we'll save that under cinematics. In here, we will add a shot track where we can add our supercar to it. We're going to find a position of this car. We're going to find a position of this car where we can see those brake lights turn on and off. So we'll just choose a camera around about here. And if we play through, we can see those brake lights turn on and turn off there. So that's what we want. We'll make sure we add a camera cut track, which we'll move up. And we will add our cine camera. And if we go to render this movie, the default settings will be fine. Press render. We can see those lights turned on and off there. If we go into where that video rendered out, we can scrub through those frames and see that brake light turned on. Go a little bit further and that brake light turned off. So we can see those recorded brake lights are now working in movie render queue as well as when we're scrubbing on that timeline, which will really reduce the amount of keyframing we need to do in an animation.